Fetches Google, part of the Google Search Console, lets you simulate how Google will render a published page, and it'll also let you submit your pages to Google's index, the goal, of course, being to get your site or changes to your site up on Google as quickly and efficiently as possible. Now, Google's pretty good at catching and indexing changes on its own, but there are two really great tools that can help in this department: Fetch and Index. Let's start with Fetch. From the Search Console, you can run a fetch under the crawl category, specifically Fetch as Google. This tool lets you see how Google renders pages from your website, which we know because on the top of the page it says, "See how Google renders pages from your website." By default, the URL field is left blank, and if we move forward without entering a specific path, the tool will fetch our homepage. Now, we have two options, Fetch or Fetch and Render. Fetch will let you see how Google views your code, and Fetch and Render will do the same thing, plus give you a visual representation of what Google sees. For right now, let's fetch and render so we can explore visually. This can take a moment, but what you're looking for is a status of complete. You can see below some alternate statuses. These will display if Google can't access your site or some of the resources on your page. This will usually only happen if you've manually blocked content on your site, if Google can't access something. But now that it's complete, we can hover over and click the row to take a closer look. And right there, we have a side-by-side. To the left, how Google sees the page. To the right, how a visitor might see your page. Of course, Google's looking for text, images, it's looking for content, things it can add to its search index. So specific layout and style considerations aren't a factor here. So don't worry if your layout and font selection look a bit odd. Now, you don't have to visually browse through every page, and you don't even have to do it with your homepage. This part can be helpful for troubleshooting, but the real killer feature here is indexing. Once you've done a fetch or fetch and render, you can request indexing. Now, this is great if we've made an update to our site or a specific page and we want to let Google know right away. So if we've updated our site and we've done a fetch on our homepage, crawling our URL and its direct links means Google will follow links from your homepage and crawl those pages too. If we've only updated a specific page or we're just looking to have Google update one URL only, we have that option as well. Now, both requests have limited submissions inside a 30-day period, so don't worry about reindexing obsessively every time you fix punctuation or update a font color. And that's it. So, we have Fetch and Render, which gives us info regarding Google's access to your site, and we have Request Indexing, asking Google to recrawl and reindex your URL. That's Fetches Google.